Good morning, students. Today we will start chapter 5 of our class 6, that is understanding elementary shapes. Okay, now understanding means we are going to grasp all the phases of these shapes. Elementary are the primary. Okay, so understanding elementary shapes means we will get to know more about our shapes. Now, first of all, we have seen different shapes like circle, triangle, square, rectangle, and 3D shapes also. We have seen cube, cuboid, cylinder, cone. Now, similarly, now when it comes like shapes we have seen. Now, we have to compare that which one is bigger, which one is smaller. So, this is also one aspect of understanding our basic shapes. Now, first of all, we are discussing only about our line segments. How we can measure line segments? Now, the first technique we can have, that is comparing by observation. Observation is simply by visualization. Supposingly, if I am drawing line segment AB and one more line segment I am drawing, that is CB. Now, the question is very simple, that which line segment is bigger? Or which one is smaller? Then you can easily say, simply by observation, that this CD line segment seems quite bigger than line segment AB. Now, supposedly here I am having a very large difference between line segment AB and line segment CD. That's why it's very easy to compare. Now, what if there is a very slight change between these two line segments, or very slight difference between these? Then we can have one another way, that is comparing by tracing. Now you all know about trace paper. Like trace paper we are using for sketching any paint or just copying that painting or any to copy any figure we are using trace paper. So by tracing also we can see, like supposingly again the same line segment I am having AB. First on a trace paper I will put my trace paper on this. Okay, trace paper, it's a translucent sheet only. So first I will put my trace paper over here. Then over it, on the trace paper, I will sketch this line segment AB. Now I am having the another one, that is CD. Now I will put that trace paper on CD. Now we can see that whether CD is less than the line segment on trace paper or CD is more than the line segment on trace paper. And by the technique of tracing, we can also compare the two line segments. Now, these are the approximate methods. Now, what can be one exact method of comparing line segment? That is by ruler or by divider. This is your ruler. Ruler is simply your scale. Now, by scale also, I can measure. If I will put, I can see, okay, fine, this is 8 centimeter. And on putting this, I can find, okay, fine, this is 10 centimeter. Then CD is bigger. So by using ruler it's very easy. Now how I can compare by divider? Again I'm making quite approximate line segment only. CD. Now if you will compare only by observation, then you will say, ma'am, both line segments are same. They both are looking same. But when I will tell you to compare it by divider, now you can see that divider we can open. If I will put my divider on this, then I have measured this line segment. Okay, you can see that this line segment is measured with this divider. Now, if I will put the same divider on it, then you can see that CD is going beyond this divider. Means CD is quite bigger than line segment AB. Okay, so in this way by divider also we can compare. Now, if I will talk about some questions of exercise 5.1, then the very first question is that what is the disadvantage of comparing any line segment by mere observation? Disadvantage means we can say drawback or negative effect of comparing any two line segment by simple observation. So, observation से जब भी आप किसी line segment को compare करते हो, तो क्या नुकसान होता है? Like, with observation, we are having an approximate idea. So, that doesn't gives us a clear picture of comparing any two line segment. So, if I will talk about the first question of exercise 5.1, 5.1, that what is the disadvantage of comparing any line segment by observation, that is, while comparing by observation, we don't have a exact idea. We don't have a exact idea of our result. Okay, or we are not sure. It's approximate value. Okay, so this is we can't say that this is the final answer. You can write it in your own words also, or you can add on something in this also, that what according to you is the disadvantage of comparing only by observation. According to me, I can say that we don't have exact idea of our result, or we are having an approximate idea which is not sure. Now the second question of the exercise 5.1 is, why we prefer to compare any line segment, or why it is better to compare any line segment by divider rather than a ruler. Means, as per this question, we have to prove that divider is better than this ruler, or divider gives us more better result than this ruler. How? How you can identify that? In scale, we don't have sharp points, but in divider we are having sharp points. So this sharp point will give a very clear picture, or very whatever is the drawback of observation, the same is the positive feedback for this divider, that with divider we are getting a more appropriate result of comparing any line segments. So that's why divider, the reason is the divider is having sharp points, so it gives us a more appropriate result as compared to the ruler. So that's why divider is better than ruler. So these are the two questions of exercise 5.1. You can write this second answer also in your own words, or whatever I am saying, you can frame my words also. Like in divider, we are having sharp points. In divider, we have sharp points. So it gives an appropriate idea. It gives an appropriate, I can say, or exact word I can use, appropriate or exact idea of our comparison. Okay, so in this way we have discussed two questions of exercise 5.1. This exercise 5.1 is very easy, it's simple on our understanding. It doesn't have any formula to solve. It's simply by your observation or by your logical reasoning you can answer all these questions. So let's discuss some more questions of exercise 5.1. Now let's see what is the third question. Third question of this exercise 5.1 is that draw any line segment AB. Okay, so I have drawn a line segment. Let's draw it. That is AB, and then take any point C on the line segment AB. This is the first task was draw line segment AB. Then take any point C on the line segment AB. Now what you have to do? We have to measure the value of with scale. You will measure the value of AB, and then you will measure the value of BC, and then you will measure the value of AC. Okay, all the three values you will measure: AC, BC, and AB. And then you will find out that whether AC plus BC, this is left hand side, just add AC and BC, and you have to check whether this sum is coming equal to AB or not. This you have to check, whether AC plus BC is equal to AB or not. Definitely by diagram we can say that yes, AC plus BC is equal to AB, and this you have to verify by measuring all these three and then adding AC BC. When you will add these two, then that should be equal to AB. So this was your third question. Now similarly in question number 4, what you have to do, A, B and C are three points on the line such that, like see, AB is equal to 5 centimeter and BC is AC is equal to 8 centimeter. BC is equal to 3 centimeter and this AC is equal to 8 centimeter. So in this it is given that A, B, C are three points such that AB is equal to 5 centimeter, BC is equal to 3 centimeter and this AC hole, this is equal to 8 centimeter. Now what you have to say that which one of these lie between A and between the other two. आपको ये बताना है इस क्वेश्चन में कि कौन सा पॉइंट किन दो के बीच में आ रहा है. सो इट्स वेरी इजी बाय सिंपली लुकिंग एट द डायग्राम ओनली. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू ड्रॉ दिस, देन वी कैन सी दैट बी लाइज बिटवीन ए सी. सिंपल बाय लुकिंग एट द डायग्राम ओनली वी कैन सी. नाउ फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, इन फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन दिस डायग्राम इज गिवन टू यू इन योर टेक्स्ट बुक. And they are asking that prove that D is the midpoint of AG. हमें ये प्रूव करना है that D जो है वो बिल्कुल बीच में आ रहा है. किस किस के A और G के बीच में क्या आ रहा है D. Now how I can prove? Let's see. If I will look at AD, AD is if I am taking this as 1 unit, 2 unit and 3 unit. So AD is equal to 3 unit. Similarly, let's see DG, 1 unit, 2 unit and 3 unit. So again, DG is also equal to 3 unit. So what we can say that AD is equal to DG. So in this way, you can simply prove this by your simple understanding. Now, by referring to this diagram only, again the question is that if B is the by looking at the diagram only we can say that question is if B is the midpoint of AC. B आपको दिख रहा है कि A और C के बिल्कुल बीच में है and C is the midpoint of BD, then why AB is equal to CD. Now let's see, if B is midpoint of AC means therefore AB is equal to BC. अगर B midpoint है AC का तो इसका मतलब ये हुआ कि AB और BC equal होंगे. Similarly also आगे आपको बता रखा है C is midpoint of BD. Also BC is equal to CD. Now look at these two. This is, so when B is midpoint of AC then AB is equal to BC. And then BC is equal to CD. Okay, तो आप देख रहे हो कि first वाले में BC AB के बराबर है लेकिन second वाले में BC CD के बराबर है. So what we can say that AB is also equal to CD. So in this way we can prove that how AB is equal to CD. Now in 7th question they are saying draw 5 triangles. Okay, 5 triangles by our wish we can draw simply 5 triangles. These are the 5 triangles. Now what you have to do, you have to measure all the sides of this 5 triangles. All the sides. 3 sides of a triangle, measure everything. And in each case, you have to see that while adding 2 sides, it should be less than the 3rd side. You can add any 2 sides. Either you can add these two or these two. Any 2 sides. By adding these 2 sides, you have to check that if in all the cases, whether the sum of 2 sides is less than the 3rd side or not. So at the end, definitely it will come. It is possible to construct any triangle only when the sum of 2 sides is less than the 3rd side. So at the end you will write, yes, the sum of 2 sides is less than the 3rd side. Okay, So I think I have discussed all the questions of exercise 5.1, and we don't have to use any formula while doing this. It's a simple logic. You can find some other way also of doing these questions. I will be more happy if you will be coming some other solutions. So in this way we have to do this. We can use any means to prove our statement. We can prove any logic, but it should be valid enough. So you can share other solutions also with me personally, and on the basis of your understanding of the concepts which I have explained today in the beginning of comparing any line segments and the questions which we have discussed, I will be giving you some important points and some questions to solve in the worksheet, and the worksheet will be attached will be given to you along with this video link. So first of all, you have to watch this video completely, and then only you have to solve that worksheet on the basis of your complete understanding. So next we will do in our next classes. Thank you, students. Thank you.